Okay guys, this week I continue to work on the Open Inverter VCU. Last time I was testing and repairing one for my subscriber. Found very interesting problem with the pull down resistor wrong value causing STM processor not going into the run mode. As a result, the software was not running and the web page was not connecting properly to the VCU. I'm going to test my VCU, which I made a while ago using Demi and Maguire design files. This is inverter I'm going to use with Toyota Prius gearbox. I will spare you the details of removing the Open Inverter board and reinstating the Prius board, as I have done it quite extensively in my previous videos you can find on my channel. First, I will need to make a small improvised wiring harness to test basic functionality of the Open Inverter VCU. So this is my first setup, so it will be reverse forward switch, start button and the ignition switch. So I'm only using this part. Okay, now time to do first functional test. So I got all the wires in place, all the switches in place, and now it's time to try to see if it actually works. So this is our harness. Now put this on. It's quite a nice locking mechanism. And now we can turn the power supply on. Here we go. So I can now see that light is flashing, so the power is applied correctly, which is already a good sign. At this point, I went through pressing all the buttons and switching all the switches, as well as checking their status in the web interface. It appears that all of the accessories and switches were working. Show gauges. Here we go. So we can see start is off and start is on. Perfect. And I'll reverse. Also working, and our forward is also working, and the start button is also working. Okay, so I've now crimped all the cables and I connected the throttle pedal, so it's pretty much the same connection as Toyota Prius I did on my Open Inverter board experiment.
With the throttle pedal, I needed to see if Hall effect sensors on the pedal are actually working. So I plotted the graph on the web interface, and while pressing the pedal, I observed the graph reading of the throttle pedal sensor positions.
I tested all my buttons and switches and they were all working well, but I hit a bit of a problem. I found whatever I tried, the inverter, or VCU I should say, would never go into the run mode. It would always remain in the off mode. Later on, I found out the problem was actually related to the throttle pedal. As I was experimenting, I connected this throttle pedal straight to the VCU, and what I found, there is a parameter in the VCU which is related to the throttle minimum value. And what basically happened is one of the wipers, one of the sensors that reading throttle position and translated into the throttle signal, was actually giving the reading about 492 of some sort of arbitrary value, and this was exceeding the throttle minimum parameter. So my throttle minimum value was set as 300, and of course it makes perfect sense that you don't want the VCU to go into run mode when your throttle is pressed. Okay, so there should be minimum threshold value above which you don't want to go into the run mode. So once I restarted the VCU and I changed my throttle minimum value, it started to go into the run mode no problem at all. But it took me a little while to find out why it was happening, and I have to say thank you to people of Open Inverter Forum that helped me out with this problem. Thank you very much, guys. So now I'm connected to the network. I don't have to just connect to the fairy link to actual Wi-Fi module. So now I saved the IP address that was assigned to my VMOS module, and I can straight away connect into the web page. What I wanted to show you that now I connected my contactors, my pre-charge and my main contactor. I will be able to operate contactor as well, but of course the main contactor will never turn on because our voltage, UDC switch voltage, is actually zero. So in this case it will only switch main contactor once the required value is reached. So I don't actually have any high voltage, so for this reason it's off. So yeah, basically what I'm doing now is I'm switching ignition on, and once I press the start button, you can hear that contactor goes, the VCU goes in the run mode, and contactor clicks. And in this case, if I test the contactor here, we can see that it's engaged. So if I now release, well, let's just do it like this. So if I now switch ignition off, oops, sorry about the noise. So you can hear that the contactor is now disengaged. And now if I, well, let's just do the auto and refresh. So we can see that it's in off mode. So let's do it again. So if I do ignition on, nothing happens. And now I press start button. We can see that it goes into run mode. And actually, if we were fast enough, we'd have seen that it says pre-charge. So contactor is engaged. So now I can do another experiment. I can put some value on contactor control on UDC SW. So let's say if I put 30 volts value, I'm not going to store it into flash because I just want to show it temporarily and not use it for future use. So now I turn ignition off and it goes off the run mode. So here we can see it goes off the run mode. And now if I go back into ignition mode and press start button, we can see pre-charge, but the system doesn't go into the run mode because it has an error message. Status is UDC below UDC SW. So our UDC SW minimum value is 30 volts, and it's never managed to reach that value. So for this reason, we have pre-charge fail, and last error message is pre-charge.